Hello everyone on YouTube, I'm MadZap, and welcome back to Crisis Core Reunion. Last time we did a bunch of stuff. I actually don't remember, it's been about a week, but we're back live again with some people in chat, so you might see some messages pop up there. And yeah, I think we're just gonna get right into this, because I don't remember what we were doing. Dealing with some Genesis clone stuff, and we're tasked with hunting down Angeal, but we're not going to actually do that. We're going to quote unquote fail. So yeah, let's get started. Oh, okay. Just got a jump scare. how do I play this game again? It's been a while. fuck. There we go. Okay, yeah, and L1's my materia, that's right. Okay, I couldn't move until the battle was over? That was a little weird. Alright, hey dude. Hey, Chef Horace, how's it going?
Hollander's laboratory is right down this way. It's a private, unsanctioned facility. We may find leads on Angeal.
Okay.
Let's go.
So I think what we have to do is... I thought there was something with these ladders that we had to do. Yeah, maybe we'll figure it out later.
Activating combat mode.
Oh, yeah. I was just about to say, I remember there's these flying guys that are kind of annoying to deal with. Oh, there's one behind me, too. Oh, they're weak to ice. Oh, well, I don't have ice right now, so I'm just gonna have to spam lightning. Yeah, more fireballs. There we go. I think that works a little bit better. It's about the same. Oh my gosh, and I'm more okay. And we have the Assault Twister. Oh, I should probably move my camera so that you can actually see my health and stuff. That'd probably be useful. Owie. I got my head bonked. There we go. Okay, time to move the camera. Whoops, I'm moving something else. I don't know what it is. There's just so many different things on my, on this scene for my OBS. Okay, I think that should be good. About there, we can always readjust it later if need be. And then we can use this to get a shortcut back to onto the other side. So if we want to go back over here, we can. And ladder time.
Activating combat mode.
Uh-oh. I still need to swap to the getting Blizzard on my loadout. Oh crap! I am out of MP. Uh-oh. Oh.
What's the matter now?
I was looking for materia, and now I'm late for my assignment.
I see.
I think we've seen this one before, but
don't you need that too? Ever the restless.
Yeah, these are just like Zack's memories, and we'll see a lot more of those. But now I should probably. Where's my basic? Wait, I don't have my basic potions. What the heck? Ow! I'm gonna die. Mind, I'm good. The battle music though. Oh wait, what happened to the other guy? What did he just run away? Excuse me.
Activating combat mode.
Oh fuck, he fled. Oh okay, well that makes sense.
Hunt.
You know, one thing that... Ow, gosh, I'm getting shanked so many times. But one thing that I found out that's very interesting to know is how many people that are watching have not actually seen a Final Fantasy game before. That's very interesting. Also, I should probably move the chat box so that it's not on top of me.
The source is...
Where should I move the chat box?
That should open the door.
Recently started playing Final Fantasy V, never played 7 though. Ooh, nice. Yeah, Final Fantasy V is like one of... I think mechanically, or like gameplay-wise, it's one of my favorites. It's not very interesting story-wise, because it's just kind of like... It's kind of got a simple story. Although there's there's some really funny parts later on, but gameplay-wise, it's really cool. 7, I think, is also good, but I feel like 7's a tiny bit overrated. Just hot take, it's a little bit overrated. It's still good, but like it's just a little bit overrated in my opinion. Oh, where should I put the chat? I guess I could shrink it. I don't know. Maybe I can just leave it where it's at. Maybe just move my face down a little bit more. Down a little bit. Yeah, I think that's fine. I think it was innovative for the time, like the jump in graphics from 6 to 7 was huge. That is true, absolutely, like, because Final Fantasy 6 was the last 2D Final Fantasy game. And Final Fantasy 7 was the first 3D one, and, I mean, the graphics haven't really aged that well, but, I mean, it was pretty impressive for the time. Oh yeah, we got, there's also missions, which we were introduced to in the first episode of this playthrough. And yeah, the missions are kind of just like bite-sized little things, but they can give some important stuff. Like, for example, on the DMW, everything on that right column is you can only unlock by going through the missions stuff. And same thing with actually the middle column for the most part. I think that the very top one isn't the exception, but yeah, pretty much everything else you have to go through the missions system to unlock it, which is kind of annoying, but all right, this is just a short cut kind of thing. Okay, never mind. Don't need to go over here. We need to go over this way and fight a Sahagin guy. Hi-yah! Ooh, no damage. Oh yeah, I forgot they added that where it was like, and the, like if you do certain things in battles, you get like different, it restores different amounts of HP and or MP and stuff like that. It's actually kind of nice. So can I combo into the power attack for... Oh, I can, so I can make that even stronger. Because with the Assault Twister, we can... If we string it into a combo, then it does more damage. And yeah, just gotta spam some fireballs. Before we do that, let me grab this chest. I see this treasure over here. We got a high potion. Let's go. Oh, and there's treasure over here. Shinra Alpha? Is this good? I thought I remembered this thing being kind of good. Hold on. Never mind, it's just Vitality 40, which is better than the Bulletproof Vest, because that's only Vitality 30. So yeah, let's go equip that. And then do this, okay. Oh, you know what I'm going to do? I just remember this. I need to actually swap out one of these. Let's swap out the fire, I guess, for Blizzard. Because I need to have Blizzard for those flying guys to make them die quicker. Oh, hi, Clilith. How's it going? Uh-oh. Hello. Oh, but these guys are weak to fire. I just realized. Uh-oh. I haven't been using the fire against them anyway, so it doesn't really matter, but... Yeah. Actually, can I even... How? Oh, whoops. Ow. Uh-oh, I'm low on health. Heal. Oh. Nice. Big chunk of damage. Welcome in, Gamer Kid. I'm not sure why you're saying L, but welcome in. How you doing? I'm okay. That's good. Glad to hear it.
Activating combat.
Oh, okay. There's a lot of random encounters in this game. If you haven't noticed. But the Blizzard does do the job, so that's good. Just a lot of encounters. What do you mean random? That's an average day in Sweden. Yeah, you're just walking along and the monster with a trident just shows up out of nowhere and starts attacking you. That does make sense. Good work. Thanks, Jeffromoth. Yes.
How wretched.
Oh yeah, so I think if we go over here and we get to see inside the big tube thing, there's more of these monsters. Look how much detail they put into it. So cool.
There's a monster inside.
Yeah, yes, good observation, Zach.
Is this where they make the copies?
Oh, I think I remember in this area there's a bunch of reading. Yeah, Project G summary. Objective: implant the cells of an ancient into a human fetus to imbue said fetus with the ancient's abilities.
It was
a monster inside. I could never tell.
The result was a normal child, which meant he failed. However,
oh, I think I. Oh no, we okay. Yeah, Sephiroth comments on all the thing. These are little documents we have to read. Okay, report on the soldier degradation phenomenon. The heightened abilities of soldier members are maintained by a delicate balance of various genetic factors. A change in this balance could only be caused by a leak of genetic information, but this is not possible under normal circumstances. This phenomenon is unique to the soldier type G.
I'm getting woozy.
Yeah, I bet half of chat is too. They're like, this lore, man, I don't get it.
The wound was superficial. But for some reason, Genesis wasn't.
But I guess a quick rundown of the lore, or like kind of like the background for this game is. So there's big super corporation by the name of Shinra. They're like an electric power company that have all these Mako reactors, because They use the energy of the planet, and they have a group called Soldier, which is just the regular word soldier, but in all caps, and they're just like super soldiers, basically. And they've been like genetically modified to be like superhuman. And yeah, I think that's kind of a general rundown of how things work. So
a soldier.
Yeah.
Type G.
And then I guess there's different types, which I think leans into kind of the three like big characters of Genesis, Angeal, and Sephiroth. Who are kind of like the most, at least at the start of the game, they're kind of considered like the most powerful. Let's see, the Ancients Project outline. It is now an undisputed fact that the life form excavated from the Earth is indeed of the ancient race spoken of in legend. Furthermore, history records that these Ancients channeled the power of this planet to tear the Earth asunder. Using the cells of the Unearthed Ancient, we have begun research on creating and mass-producing a race with comparable abilities. The primary objective of this research is to significantly reduce Mako excavation costs. So, yeah, that kind of explains the Ancients, which is what I was going to get to next, but... let's save our game! I like saving! And I think that's all the reading we had to do, thankfully, so let's go over here. Personally, I'm okay with reading lore documents in games, but I know that's not exactly exciting to watch, so...
Project Genesis. Contrary to this report, Genesis showed clear signs of change.
Degrading?
Not only that.
Copies?
Abominations.
Sephiroth.
Oh, hey, dude.
Hollander, I thought I'd find you here.
You want to do something to me, eh? But then, who will stop Genesis and Angeal?
Yeah, so this is Hollander, who's the bad scientist. And that's Genesis. With his Genesis. Cool one wing.
You won't take Hollander.
Zack, go.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. This part of the game's kind of funny. Because it, like, doesn't make a whole lot of sense in a way, but... I'll explain it when we get to it.
There is no hate, only joy. For you are beloved by the goddess. Hero of the dawn, healer of worlds.
Loveless again, you never change.
Three friends go into battle.
Yeah. Is captured. Genesis loves quoting the play Loveless.
A common story.
If we were to enact it, would I be the one to play the hero, or would you?
It's all yours.
Indeed. After all, your glory should have been mine.
How petty.
In hindsight, perhaps. Now what I want most is the gift of the goddess.
Is the audio good, by the way? Or does it need to be boosted?
You won't get away. Where is Angeal? Tell me!
Activating combat mode.
Bring it on!
Okay, back into the action. Oh, whoops, I accidentally just used up a high potion. I didn't mean to do that. Ow, oof. Ow, I didn't even get to see, to tell that he was doing the jump. Okay. Just heal up and block.
Ah,
Okay. Yeah, I'm getting kind of low on health. Oh yeah, I can just do this, right? Yeah. I can just use my super move. I think I'm gonna boost the game audio just a wee little bit. There we go. Maybe that's a little too much, actually. There we go. Just fine-tuning it. Fancy. Yeah, we got a cool punchy move.
Activating combat mode.
Yeah, this part's just kind of funny because Hollander is like this basic, like, human scientist who's just, like, so good at running away somehow. Hiya! There we go. I like saving. Gosh, I'm becoming Markiplier. He says that all the time. Okay, I've got a Soma, which is to recover my AP. And Hollander sneaks on by, and somehow we don't notice until he's gone. I think you actually can do a fight here, but I don't see any treasure, so I'm not gonna do it. I'll be lurking and saying hi every once in a while. Alright, thanks for the lurk, Popsy. Hope you're doing well. Audio seems decent level, at least on OBS. So yeah, we got the airstrike. Sure, let's just call it an airstrike, that's fine. You know.
No, not if I can help it.
I forgot that they changed the line. Man. Not as funny anymore. It used to be a funny limit break, and now it's just kind of a normal limit break. Okay, I don't know if it actually matters which way we go here, so I'm gonna go left and fight some people. Ow. How do I switch lock? Okay, I have to. Oh no. Hiya. Gonna blast me with the fire today. Oh, I was actually a little worried that he was gonna hit me there. But he did not. Any treasures around here? Nope, just more combat. That's how that works. The way to switch targets is a little weird, but it's not too bad. You have to like hold L1 down and do it.
Conflict resolved.
Oh yeah.
And still no treasure.
Activating combat.
Got a fight here. Just so many battles. What's chat's opinion of random encounters in games? Like, I'm actually okay with it, but okay. Really got that block off. Yeah, I'm okay with random encounters, but I know there's a lot of people who don't like them. Hit everyone with that.
Oh,
nice, we leveled up. Level 11, baby.
Activating combat mode.
Oh my gosh, why are there Why are there these... What did we call them in the last stream? I think, like, vacuum cleaners or something. I like to call them RC cars. All under on, he's just so fast, oh no! I have to find my more dudes!
Activating combat mode. Right there.
Okay, we can do a chain slash. I think that hits everyone.
Here we go. Go, go, go.
Does it? Nope, it just hits one person. Never mind, okay. Oh, can you please attack the guy that's closer to you? Thank you, game. Much appreciated it. There we go. Jump. Oh, we got the ability to jump now? Ooh. Interesting. I'm going to... heal with cure first. Can I? Okay, nice. I can just do that. There we go. What do we want to? Let's replace the power attack with jump. I want to see how jump works. I know how it works normally in Final Fantasy games, but I just want to see how they do it in this. Oh no, Hollander is getting away! I'm definitely going the right way! Oh, okay. I thought there was gonna be a lot more over here. It's just a little treasure chest. And, oh yeah, this boss battle is, I remember this boss battle being real annoying. Because you have all three of these guys to deal with. Ow, 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 ow. Let's see, okay, let's try this jump thing. Hiya! Okay, you just jump. You just do a big old jump and then you come crashing down. Okay. Maybe we should just try using our spells and stuff on them. That might be better. Oh yeah, for the missile guy, I remember we have to block that. And yo. Oh, okay. No, we can just dodge it. We don't have to block it. Okay. Go. Spam thunder until they die. Ow. Ouch. Ooh, we're getting the summon wheel. Oh, well, we didn't get Ifrit. Come on. Kite them around. And spam thunder. There we go. Okay, we got one down. You are weak to ice, apparently. Oh, I'm out of MP. Uh-oh. Use an Aether. I'm gonna use a second one. Ow, okay, I'm getting killed. Ouch. Can't spam ice on him. Ow, 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 ow. Okay, please stop shooting me. It hurts a lot. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna die because it keeps shooting me. Stop shooting me. Okay, you're dead. I'm gonna use Octa Slash on you. Ay-yi-yi. How much damage did that deal? Ooh, a good amount. Okay. Try to dodge the missiles if I can. There we go. And then I'm just gonna slash you. Oh, okay. I was gonna try to combo into my jump, but instead I just got hit with missiles. It's fine.
Better run for it. Prove your honor to me.
I got it.
These limit breaks are always so over the top.
Oh, yeah.
There we go.
Conflict resolved.
Whew. That was a lot easier in this one than it was when I played the PSP version.
Hollander,
I remember it took so long to get through that boss fight on the PSP.
Working for Hollander now? What is it you're after?
World domination.
That's not even funny, man.
How about revenge?
For what? And deal!
Whoa, he has a white wing! Oh my gosh!
I've become a monster. A monster's objective is usually world domination or revenge.
You're wrong. Those aren't the wings of a monster.
Well then, what are they?
Angel's wings.
I see. Then what should an angel fight for, Zack?
I like to think that Angel's just
what
like, Zack, that's cringe.
Angels dream of one thing.
Please, tell me.
To be human.
Oof. Gut punch both emotionally and physically. But also, we just got punched like 20 feet away. So, you know, that's a thing.
Defend yourself.
And there we go. And then it just says, you died. Oh, I'll definitely save my game. I love saving.
Tell me what happened.
Mom? I want to help out a friend, but I don't know how I can do it.
Hello?
Mom?
Hello?
Yep, hooray. Now we're here, apparently.
Heaven?
Not quite. It's a church. Hmm?
An angel?
No, I'm Aerith. You fell from the sky.
Huh?
Scared me.
So you saved
yeah,
me.
Yeah, wasn't there.
Not
okay,
really.
So. I don't remember, or quite remember.
Hello.
The original.
That's all I did.
Final Fantasy VII, but I think wasn't Aerith's name Aeris in there? Or I remember there's this whole like debate on if her name should have actually been Aeris or Aerith or something like that. It was weird.
I have to repay you somehow.
But it's pretty much established as Aerith now, so I don't know what it was, but it's kind of going now.
Aha! Hey, how about one date?
What is that?
Also, meanwhile, Zack is casually trying to, you know, flirt with this person he just met 5 seconds ago. You know, as you do.
Stop! Don't step on the flowers.
Excuse me?
Normally, people are more careful with flowers.
Well, I guess I'm not normal. Oh. You don't see a lot of flowers in Midgar. They're like luxury items around here.
They only grow here. Although, I planted some outside my house, too.
If I were you, I'd sell them.
Hmm?
Midgar is full of flowers. Your wallet's full of money.
But yeah, this whole chapter of the game is pretty much the wholesome chapter, so... And just buckle up, everyone.
Never thought of it that way.
Let's go, Aerith's in the DMW. Aerith's Limit Break is really good because it just heals you a bunch. And I think it removes status effects or something like that, but yeah, it's pretty nice. Okay, let's just save because I like saving. And then should we do some missions to dip into those a little bit? I think... Okay, so if we go into here... I'm trying to remember. There's a way you can unlock Bahamut, but I don't remember what it is. I think you have to go into here, and then you have to get to, like, one of these, like, question mark ones. So we could just, you know, let's just run through a few of these, like, basic ones. Try to get to it. Alright, let's go. Plus, we can do some materia fusion stuff.
Activating combat mode.
What the heck? What is going on with the... It's like... The sparks look weird here. Is that just me? There's something weird about how the lighting looks in this area. I don't know what it is. There's something wrong. Potions, let's go. Oh yeah, I can sprint. I forgot about that.
Activating combat mode.
Bring it on.
Yeah, we're just fighting a bunch of birds right now. Don't worry about it.
Ooh.
Fancy. Actually, I don't want to get into this cord. Okay, next one. So, we go down to here. And then, I guess it probably didn't have to do that one. But, okay, let's do this one. Again, mission. Okay, why is it explaining to me how to do a mission? I've done, like, two already. In case you didn't know how missions worked, here's how it works.
Activating combat mode.
It's pretty much all the missions are is just run around, kill a few guys, and then you'll get a reward.
Conflict resolved.
Oh yeah.
I think we gotta go this way. Oh, nice! They kept that in where if you skirt around the edges, you can actually just dodge the fights. I remember I was when I recorded the PSP version for this game. I did this a lot where I just skipped past all the fights.
Activating combat mode.
Because I was having to do a lot of missions to try to get some of like the. Some of the cool, like, DMW stuff at the end. You can get a Chocobo, and you can get the Tonberry. Great characters, but, they take forever to get to with the DMW, and so I would just grind out the missions and just run past all the fights. Okay, so now we get access to the rematch with Bahamut. There we go. So we just kick Bahamut's butt again, and we can actually use him. Ow. Hey, level up. He like how I jumped up with him. Block stuff, punch him a bit. I think we're gonna be punching his toes. Yeah, punch them toes. Your feet are really gonna hurt after this one. That's so goofy. Ouch. Okay. Heal up. Ow. Okay, so if I use this Octa Slash, that should stop the Bahamut from using his ability. Because he's doing the charge up thing or whatever. There we go. And I killed him. I wasn't even paying attention to the health bar. But we got him. Let's go. And so now we can get him as a summon for the BMW. Yeah, you know, our BMW. You know, we can just... I'm gonna just have access to him. whoops, I didn't mean to save. So what's after him? I think it's just, yeah, it's some random stuff. But okay, we can do... we can combine this thunder with this thunder to get a better thunder. Gonna be like only a slightly better thunder, but...
It's better.
Get a higher magic boost. And I think we can do the same thing with the HP ups. Nope, it doesn't do anything. ooh, if we combine it with the power attack, we get a plus 60 boost. Okay. If we combine it with thunder, it'd be plus 70. Interesting. I think I'm gonna hold off on it then. Just because it sometimes, or we'll get some more magic materia eventually, so. Oh yeah, isn't it like, if you start, stop. Oh yeah, if you start walking into the flowers, Aerith gets made.
Sorry.
Okay. I guess we just walk over here, and then we get cutscene.
Are you always here?
Yeah. So, where are you going?
Don't know.
I'll take you.
Where?
Don't know.
You just want to spend more time with me.
Yeah.
Huh?
Zach's like, uh-oh, teasing failed. Uh-oh. Now it's awkward.
We're... under the plate, right? Sector 5. The slums.
Yeah. Main street's over that way. There's lots of people. And you can
I like how they redesigned this area.
Well, I should be good.
At least from that one shot where we actually got to see the environment.
Okay, let's go.
They actually put a lot more detail into this. This was kind of awkwardly empty in the original, I felt like. But yeah, they did a good job with flushing it out. And yeah, of course, you know, because it's the escort mission type of thing, Aerith walks super slow.
Hey, it's still a ways.
Okay. Thanks for reminding me. Just, you know, go at the regular walking speed. Don't go any faster. Nope, just go the It's just as bad as the first game. Oh, wait. Hello?
You think flowers would grow here?
Apparently, Zach does not feel the need to answer that. Did Aerith walking.exe has broken? Or do I have to go on ahead? I had to go on ahead. Oh no, there's monsters! What the heck?
Zach, let's run!
Don't worry about it. I'll protect you. I've got this.
You've got this?
Oh yeah. Stay back, okay?
Yeah, I got my cool sword. Oh yeah, these things are called hedgehog pies. Don't know why. It's kind of weird, but
oh yeah,
that's what they're called.
You're amazing. You're so strong.
Strong. Like a monster, right?
Zach, what's wrong?
Nothing. Now, let's move.
Nothing. I was just having an emotional conversation with my mentor before he punched me down in through the main plate of Midgar, and I fell like 10,000 feet. You know, no big deal.
Dunno.
Come on, flatter me.
Oh, hey, Carpet. How's it going? Hello. Or is it Carpet? Or I've heard. Hello. I think I've heard on people on other streams call you Desi. Is that correct? Or am I messing it up with another person? Well, hi. How's it going? We're just watching this NPC slowly walk towards the area that we need to go. My name is Desi? Okay, I'll have to try to remember that, but good to know. Oh, hey, Ellie, how's it going?
Hey, wait!
So,
what's happening?
Something wrong?
The slums.
We were chasing after a scientist dude by the name of Hollander, and then we ran into Angeal again. Angeal shows off White Wing and gets all angsty, and then he does a magical punch and we fall through the floor, which was all the way up there somewhere, down into here, and now we're walking with Aerith, who's just, you know, taking her sweet time to walk to the next important spot of the game. it's great.
Kind of stuffy here.
You okay?
I know why. There's no sky here.
Yeah, there is. You see the between the poorly the extremely pixelated ceiling.
You're under this plate all the time.
Is this a different
You've
waifu?
Never seen the sky.
Pretty much, yeah.
Sorry, I'm not normal.
This is actually kind of like the main one of this game.
The sky frightens me, like it's sucking me in. Weird, right?
Normal is overrated.
You think so?
Yeah.
I know. One day, I'll show you a pretty sky.
Congrats on Hydro Elite. Thank you. Yeah, I've been saving up for months and months on that. Took me forever, but I finally got it. So sad I didn't witness it. Oh, hey, Miss Grace. How's it going? I didn't think I'd see this game when it popped up. Oh, yeah, I, the Discord notification was kind of, I didn't change the title and category before I started, or I, like, clicked start stream, so, yeah, that's kind of what happened there. But, hi, Miss Grace, how you doing? Okay. Enter the market. I don't remember, why are we going to the market? I think we have to build a wagon. If this is the wagon building part of the game, I hate this. This part sucks.
Looks like an interesting place.
Get back from my internship. Yeah. I'm mentally exhausted. Oh man, I can believe that.
Sorry.
Be careful, huh?
Okay. Sorry again.
How was it? Was he good?
Man, that hurt. Huh? Wait. What the?
What's wrong?
My wallet's gone.
Oh no!
What could have possibly happened to it?
He just stole my wallet. Aerith, wait here, okay? I'm gonna go catch that.
It was good for a learning experience, but sad cases. Oh man.
Bruno's his name.
I didn't hear about that.
You know his name.
I hope he can find some time to relax now.
Just a little. He doesn't do things like
re-energize and all that.
If he really stole from you, I'm sure he had good reason. Hey, I'll go look for him. Zach, you wait here.
All right, I'll wait here. But I'm pretty antsy.
Yeah, I know.
That obvious? Theft is theft, no matter the reason. I'll have to give him a good scolding.
And then while Zach's waiting, he's just doing his signature squats.
It's my wallet that was stolen. I'm gonna look for Bruno too. I think he went that way.
Okay, no, this is the Okay, so that everything that happens in this area of the game kind of sucks, in my opinion, because you just have to run around and talk to people.
To the right place. Everything from top of the line to cheap junk.
I feel like they changed how this character is designed. I mean, they're just NPCs, but.
Did he go out?
The NPC seems so out of place.
Hey, you there! Did a kid come running this way? A little boy?
A little boy? Don't know. Although, children never come this way.
I see.
Got your pocket picked, did you?
Huh?
Happens all the time here.
It happens all the time around here, kid. You'll get used to it.
Ask folks around here nicely, and they might help you.
Yeah, that's a good point. Right. I'll ask around here, for starters.
Krista found himself in a... He's a guy wondering why a guy with spiky hair is running around with a massive sword. Yeah, some of these NPCs kind of look out of place. Yeah, like this guy, I don't know, the hair is just it's a little, well, interesting choice.
Excuse me, got a minute?
What is it?
I'm looking for a kid named Bruno who took my wallet. Maybe you've seen him around?
I also like how he's standing outside of a shop named Item World.
Like
sure, I'll help you. Bruno, you said? Yeah, no problem.
You're the man! If you see him, it'd be great if you could catch him, too. Where did he go?
There he is. Hey, mister, that's him. Get him. He got away.
I did try to grab hold of him.
Okay, run the footage back. He clearly did not do anything except for rotate in place.
Steal my most prized materia. And well, once he used it, there was no chance.
You too. You didn't even try to chase him.
Come on now. That's not true at all.
Come on, man.
Zach!
Hey.
But yeah, this part of the game kind of goes on for a hot minute where we're just trying to get our wallet back from this snot-nosed kid. Well, let's talk to this dude who also looks out of place. What is going on with the his style, man?
I keep my materials here, so hands off.
Okay. I'm just trying to ask for help, dude. He's just like, hands off my stuff, dude.
Welcome. What do you need?
No, I'm not shopping.
It's like if Justin Timberlake stated,
I'm looking for a kid named Bruno who took my wallet.
Failed to go solo at making coffee. Okay, so yeah, then. Yeah, we have to talk to this dude. Similar cutscene's gonna happen, but we just have to bear through it. Actually, am I able to skip through this at all? I can't skip the scene, but it's more enjoyable if we suffer through the boring cutscenes than if we just skip them.
Hey, mister! That's him! Get him!
Whoa! This kid's pretty fast.
Hey, what's the deal? He's gone.
Yeah, sorry. I'm really not that quick on my feet.
You had no intention of chasing him.
No, that's not true at all.
Come on.
I like how the guy's not even looking at us. He's just like, no, that's not true at all. I definitely had an intention of chasing him. I like saving. Okay, so then I think we go to here, and then I think a similar kind of cutscene happens here, but I don't remember.
For a little boy named Bruno.
It's like, nah, I won't even give him my full attention. I don't know, right? He's just ignoring us. He's so rude.
Like this.
I haven't seen. Wait, I did see him.
Really?
That way, I think.
That way?
Yes, way down there.
Great, thanks. Hey! Wait, he's over by you.
Oh, sorry, I get my lefts and rights mixed up all the time.
Hey, lady, what gives?
I didn't mean to trick you. I just have really bad eyesight.
Okay, honestly, her excuse is even worse than the one I was joking.
Oh, I see. I'll come back.
Hey, Aerith.
Zach!
Did you find him yet?
No. But give me more time. I'll find him.
I need more time. Which equates to, you must watch more annoying cutscenes. Actually, no, I think we're done.
Aerith, how goes?
Zach.
No, I think we're good. Let's just talk to Aerith. I don't think we need to check out any more of the shops for help.
It's just bad luck. Hey, why don't we look together?
But...
Don't worry about it. I'm not gonna yell at him straight from the top. I'll ask him why he did it. And I'll forgive him if it was for a good reason.
And then I'll scold him.
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay, let's go look.
Yeah, but we still have no leads.
If Bruno needed money, he should still be around here.
Yeah.
Also, let's just ignore the fact that this whole area is like just one kind of small circle. So, like, finding him should be pretty easy, but, you know, whatever. Let's see, I think we... Do I have to talk to this character?
Hey, mister. You look pretty busy.
Okay, I don't... Okay, never mind. I thought I remember there was a cutscene with that character.
Aha! I found you!
Whoa!
Okay. No more running.
Finally! Alright. You know what you did was bad, don't you? You should never steal from people.
Zach?
Because it's very, very wrong. Now, tell me why you did it.
None of your business.
What you...
Bruno, did you really steal?
Did you really steal, even though we have proof that you did, in fact, steal Zach's wallet?
So, why did you do that? You know, Aerith believed in you. No matter what I said, she insisted you're a good boy. You can shut me out.
But yeah, this,
Aerith, the truth.
Like I said, this part of the game's kind of slow.
Tell me why.
I need medicine, but my wallet was eaten by a monster. That's why I took this guy's wallet. I thought if he's your friend, he might give me a break.
Here's the bigger question. How did this kid's wallet get eaten by a monster? Like, what was he possibly doing? The monster was just like, yoink, I'm gonna eat that.
Okay. Now we're friends again. Zach, you agree?
You believe in him, so yes.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
But you need medicine, right?
Yeah. It's for my grandpa.
Alright, I don't know if this actually... if this choice actually matters, or if we just end up having to fight the monster anyway. I want to fight stuff though, so let's do that.
Huh? Really?
Leave it to me.
But it's dangerous.
Don't you worry. Monsters around here are cake.
Okay, but I'm going to.
The monsters aren't a piece of cake. They just are cake. Oh, that's a big difference, man.
The monsters should still be on the path that goes to the park. I think. Here. Take back your wallet. I think you're gonna need it.
He wants the whole experience. Exactly.
The park is this way.
Hey, you! Get back inside the gate now! Monsters coming out of the park in droves!
I like how this guy is, you know, screaming like, there's monsters, we gotta get back behind the gate. And then his character is just like, there's monsters, we gotta get past behind the gate.
They owe me some money, so I have to go over and collect.
I mean, a lot of the way that the characters, like, move in these scenes are very, like, very much like how the original PSP was, where it would just be like, there's like five different generic animations and they just swap between them whenever they're like in a conversation. But, oh yeah, there's these kind of monsters.
Here I come.
Activating combat mode.
They're very shiny. Oh, I gotta stop. You. I mean, yeah, they are kind of disgusting.
Oh, here we are. One
look like intestines.
Is the money still inside?
Whoa!
Yeah, they're mutated intestines. They have just they become sentient and leave
Whoa!
The body.
We got it back! Amazing! Ugh, it's so sticky.
Stop complaining. At least you got it back.
Zach, were you okay?
No problem at all. Piece of cake.
Thanks a lot, mister.
Hello there. Call me
Hi,
Zach.
Ed. How's
if
it going?
You need more help, just ask. You don't need to steal anymore.
Thank you for the hydrate.
Thanks, but you've got bigger money problems than me.
Well, maybe so. But hey, just you wait. Aerith and I,
how much gil do I have?
Huh?
We're launching Operation Midgar Full of Flowers.
The currency in Final Fantasy games is called gil, by the way. So,
yes.
Midgar, if you ever hear me say gil, it's because I'm talking about the money.
Full of money.
Aerith, for real?
Yeah, for real. That's why, if you're in trouble, we can help you.
All right.
Man, yeah, how's it going, Ed? How you doing?
Okay, mister. Aerith, thanks.
I'm asleep now, sorry, but
hey,
I streamed.
Did you mean it?
Alright, no problem. Good night, Popsy.
Flowers?
Of course.
Hope you have a good sleep.
There's no turning back after this. I know. Let's make a wagon.
A wagon?
Yes, a flower wagon. With a wagon to carry lots of flowers.
Oh gosh, this is the part where we have to build a wagon. Uh-oh.
Oh, not feeling it?
No, no. It's great. Let's do it.
Alright, oh yeah, Aerith follows me. Forgot about that part. Alright, hey dude.
Oh, Aerith. Here with your boyfriend today?
Mm-mm. I just met him.
Doing great, how about you? I'm doing pretty good.
Chasing a kid around here earlier. I heard about you from the local townsfolk.
Now just playing,
were some shady outside.
This is a Crisis Core.
Like you're a decent guy.
Do you actually... Okay, I know we got a couple other people who weren't really here in the first stream, or at least I don't remember. But, how many people in chat have played or seen a Final Fantasy game before?
No, no.
I'm kind of curious.
I just met him today. Oh, wait. Could we take a look?
Huh?
Nope.
You came out to go shopping?
Okay. Forget it.
No, I'm joking. Go take a look.
Thank you. Just a look. I'll be quick.
Oh, I think this part is just like,
do you like this store?
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's explained funny. In a second what thinking. Is happening, but I think we're basically
hey,
just like,
Aerith.
Uh-huh.
We're on our way to build the wagon, and we stopped by over here.
Hello. I'll buy you something.
Your offer was one date, no?
But then you said, don't be silly, remember?
Well, I...
Okay, a memento. For today.
You mean it?
Of course.
Okay.
Seen people play it, but I've never played Final Fantasy games before.
All
okay,
right, it's yours.
Interesting.
Hold on. How's that?
Does it look right?
I think so. Yeah, it looks great.
And there's the pink bow.
Thank you, Zach. I'll treasure this.
Yeah.
Hey, do you still have time?
I guess so. Why?
Wanna go to the park?
The funny part about that pink bow is that's like,
that sounds like a date.
Because you know, Aerith is in the main Final Fantasy VII. Oh yeah, go to the park. Let's go right now.
Let's go.
I'll show you the monsters I killed along the way. But it's like Aerith is in the main Final Fantasy VII game, and she has that pink bow, and it's just like, it's one of those things where it's like, nobody was thinking about, like, where did she get the bow? But then it just, like, has this explanation.
Heroes to children,
you know?
Protectors of the peace.
It's just kind of amusing to me.
But
how romantic.
they get some kind of special surgery, don't they?
Oh, in this part, Aerith is like, the people from Soldier are scary. And Zack's like, yeah, they're so scary, right? Yeah, it's like, it's definitely not like a part of Soldier or anything like that.
They're weird, huh?
And they're scary. They fight. And they love it.
Actually, I'm with Soldier.
I'm sorry.
Well, this just got real awkward. Anyways, so...
The face?
How's the weather?
Nice. You like them? Then take a closer look. Eyes infused with Mako energy. A Soldier trademark.
Oh, you.
Color of the sky, right?
Uh-huh.
Not
scary at all.
I'll admit, things haven't been normal at all lately. What about you, Aerith? How's your life going?
I was thinking it would be a normal day. But then suddenly, some guy fell out of the sky.
That's not all that bad.
Oh. Zack, return to the Shinra building now.
Ah, crap. I'm getting called into work.
On my way. I'm sorry, but duty calls.
Well, I guess I should get going then.
Smooth pickup lines.
Will I see you again?
Of course.
I hope that your friend's okay, Zack.
Huh?
You talk in your sleep.
Yeah. It'll be fine. I know that now.
Okay, so this is not the wagon part of the game. The wagon part of the game is really slow. Okay, instead we have to go up to back on top of the plate, because so the place we're in is called Midgar. And it's like a two-floored city. Because there's like this floor, which is like on the actual ground, and then there's that up there, which is the plate. And it's this huge thing that is way too big. Yeah, we gotta go up onto the top half. The heck? After acquiring certain special items, the DMW may enter Chocobo mode. When all three reels match, you can call forth Chocobo and other creatures to register for missions where you can acquire the special items. Thanks for explaining me this thing that is normally like a hidden secret part about the game. Okay, that's weird. If you acquire the items below, you can increase the number of accessories you can equip. Keychain and backpack. Increasing the number of equipable accessories will allow you to boost parameters to prevent status ailments more easily. Aid you greatly in clearing future missions. Yeah, so like I was mentioning earlier, the missions have some like useful stuff that's like buried. But I do appreciate that they're at least telling you like, hey, here's a lot of useful things that... Or, actually, I might want to buy stuff. But yeah, here's some of the, like, useful things you can get out of the missions. Yeah, I think you're item world, so can I actually, like, buy from you?
Damn it. Stupid delivery service.
Gosh dang it, my freaking Amazon package was broke again.
They must have dropped them.
Oh, say, friend, you look pretty quick on your feet.
Mm-hmm. No, actually, I'm not. What if I just say no?
Okay, no problem. Well, have a look at my wares then.
It's just like, okay. Have a look at my wares. He says, have a look at my wares, and then he doesn't let me go look at his shop. Okay, I guess we'll have to do a side quest.
Oh, yeah. I had a feeling about you. Now, how'd you like to do a job for me? You just need to collect material you find on the street. It's really easy. Won't take long at all.
Oh, I forgot about this. This is a weird, like, mini-game.
Things easier for you. I asked everyone in the neighborhood to stay indoors. So use those fast legs and go get some materia.
Because, yeah, we have to just run around and pick up some materia. See how quickly you can collect the 20 materia that are scattered throughout town. Your finish time will affect how much gil you will receive, so be as efficient as possible and speak to the clerk when you collected all 20. Yep, so this is how this works. It's so cool. I probably could have done this a little bit faster, but...
I see you found all 20 materia for me. Your time is... pretty darn good. Yeah, not bad at all. So anyway, here's what you earned.
60 gil for running around in a circle.
Right. Come by again. There's always more work.
Okay, yeah, so we don't talk to that guy for items. Is there anyone that's an actual item shop here? Because, like...
from gifts, if you need
yeah, you just are just dialogue. You're not an actual shop. Is this person an actual shop?
Welcome, shopper.
Welcome to the item shop. We don't actually sell anything, but welcome. Oh, wait, that... I know why. It's because... okay, I'm dumb. The reason why they don't sell stuff... it's because it's in the pause menu right here. So we can just buy it whenever. Oh, whoops. Yes. And I guess it's just a remedy. Well, whoops. Okay, is there anything here that I want? What actually it would be kind of nice to buy like another thunder so we could combine that with the HP up. Yeah, let's buy it with just one. And then go to Materia Fusion. Go down to this and then go over to here. Why is that? Oh, it's because it's a higher level, isn't it? Yeah, because then you see this one's HP up plus. Whereas this one's just HP up with plus 70 HP. I don't really get it, man, but... okay, so I guess that's how that works. It's a little annoying, but... anyways. Yeah, let's go back to the Shinra building. Continue without unlocking Chocobo mode. Chocobo mode can be unlocked at any time by attaining a special item through chests on certain missions. It just don't worry about it, game. It's fine.
Hey!
Oh, hey, Bruno.
Mister, you're leaving? It's a good thing I caught you. Here, I wanted to give you this materia before you go. I promise I'll never steal again. That's why I want you to keep this for me.
Alright, I'll never steal again because you have that power now. So yeah, now we have the steal materia.
I'm glad I was a good role model.
Mister, don't use that materia to do bad things.
Of course not.
Well, never mind that. There was one more thing I wanted to say.
So I think the steal materia actually is pretty useful.
A lot harder to be worthy of Aerith.
You must be worthy of Aerith.
Between you and
must
me,
be worthy of the waifu.
Pretty sure Aerith is really sweet on you, mister. Well, I'm rooting for you, okay? If you need help, come talk to me, okay? See ya.
Looks like I gained a lot of trust. Well, I'll hold on to this materia then.
Yeah, the steel material lets us steal items from enemies, which I think could potentially allow us to get, allow us to get, materia, but I'm not actually sure. Alright, let's save, of course. And dip into the equipment a little bit. Okay, so actually, if we want to use this to just fuse with the HP up, I'm just gonna equip it. And then I think I'm gonna replace jump with steel. So yeah, let's do that. See how that goes. Uh-oh. Yoink, get a magic Mako stone. I don't remember what that does, but that does something. Hey, I've got an ether. Nice. And another magic Mako stone. Okay. Oh, and then we got Aerith's limit break. Not really useful right now because it just heals us. Okay, and then we're introduced to these enemies that are quite ridiculous. They just got drills for heads, which is a little weird, but I guess they're into that. Oops, I keep messing things up. Okay, actually, steel might not be that useful if we just keep getting Mako stones, because they do something weird with, like, materia, but I don't remember what it is. I just remember it's, like, kind of complex and annoying. Oops, I meant to do thunder. There we go.
Conflict resolved.
That's enough! I'm in a hurry!
I love that they just come out of thin air.
There's just no end to them.
Suddenly enemies.
Fine, fine. Come and get it. I'll take on all of you.
Activating combat mode.
Just ignore the fact that most of them are just standing around. Ow. Ruin my combo, dude. Here, let's do the heal. Say, this is like a super healing for free. And ta-da, we get full restore. Oh, whoops, I'm gonna do that. Yeah, if we're just getting a bunch of Mako stones, I'll probably switch steel off for something else. Okay, but it would help if I actually hit the enemy. There we go. Doink. Getting a good amount of ethers, though.
Conflict resolved.
Finally, some peace. But they ate up a lot of time. Gotta hurry.
Oh yeah, we're just And then there's this guy who's just like a super Genesis clone.
Yeah, no need to remind me.
That stung. It's like a curse in Jujutsu Kaisen. Riffraff, are we?
Ha, no problem. Activating combat mode.
Ow. You have anything cool to steal? Venom Shock. That's at least a cool name of a piece of gear. Oh crap, we're silenced. Can't use magic. Ow. Oh yeah, they like to spam the twin kick. Okay, we're just dazed. Stop kicking me, man. Oh crap, I died. Well, I got a little unattentive of my health, apparently. Reach out when Zach's HP reaches zero during a battle, game over screen will be displayed, but you try starting from that battle. You try from starting point of battle, okay, then it's like there's different ways or different spots you can do. I can reveal my equipment. Ooh. That's nice. I can change out my stuff. Yeah, I can get the steel out of here. I don't care about it. Let's go back to jump, because jump is fun. And then, actually, can I... am I able to actually do the thing? It's still 60. Is it because this... Why is it different? I don't know. I don't have this one equipped, so I might as well. Sure, why not? Now we get 20% more HP. Let's go. And okay. Yes, let's go. Oh, dang it, he got me with silence. Ooh, we get the Mega Flare? Yes, please.
Better run for it.
Just call up Bahamut and be like, hey, yeah, can you send, like, your nuke over here? And the... That the summon cinematics here are just crazy. This huge blast and it just like 2,000 damage. Okay, you can just not do the thing I inputted. That works, disturbed.
Is that it? That's it, right? I'm off.
Okay, and then... Whoa, Tarzan Geo. He's so cool.
I need your help.
Do you? Honestly. What are you thinking, Angeal?
I'm not really sure myself.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
At times I feel as if my mind is mired in fog. But Zach, no matter what happens, I have to protect my honor. As long as I hold the Buster Sword. Zach, join my battle. Our enemy is all that creates suffering.
Our enemy is all that creates suffering. It's just such a cheesy line.
carry you there.
No, wait, I...
Flying feels pretty good.
No, honestly, having a guy with a wing just pick me up and carry me over to a spot is a pretty fun way to fast travel.
You look thin. On to business. I'm certain Hollander has ordered Genesis to eliminate Hojo.
Hojo? As in...
Yes. The director of the Shinra Science Department. Hollander believes Hojo robbed him of his rightful position.
Then their target has to be the science department upstairs.
Forget about Hojo.
Same old Sephiroth. Fine. Then you take the lower levels. I'll go outside. Zack, go up. I leave Hojo to you.
You got it!
Yeah, so Hojo's the other scientist dude in this game. And, Hojo's kind of okay, like, on, like, the good guy versus bad guy spectrum, he's kind of in the middle, but, it's definitely not where he's at in the main Final Fantasy VII. He's in a completely different location, but, gotta kill some RC cars. No damage. Nice. One of these. Alright, can we go? Yeah, there's like a little side area. I don't know if there's anything in here, but I remember that there was this side area. Ooh. You see that? My assault twister killed two of them at once. Aren't all these locked? Yeah, these are all locked. No, it's just a room with a bunch of locked doors. I don't really get it, but I guess they thought they should put that in the game. Okay, then we go over here. X potion, nice. Okay, we don't know what X potions are. They're basically just, there's like regular potion, high potion, and then X potion. So it's just kind of like the best kind of potion. And I guess we just go down here.
Professor, are you...
He's just very fascinated by this machine in front of him. He's just thinking deeply about it and what it means.
Good, you're safe.
What is the data telling him?
Hey, the building is under attack by Genesis. Their target might be you, Professor.
And so, you are my protection?
Anyway, can you come with me, please?
Degrading monsters are nothing to fear.
Are you... talking about Genesis?
This dude is definitely a good guy.
Indeed I am. A memento from a bygone era, when men could deem any unclassified life form an ancient.
Unclassified life form?
The celestial calamity, Genova.
Oh boy, Genova. Genova is such a weird part of this Final Fantasy VII game.
Follow your orders and protect me.
Oh, also, since I know that there's some people who have never even watched a Final Fantasy game before, the main numbered Final Fantasy games, like, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, blah, 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 they're not connected to each other. They're, like, completely separate, like, worlds and stories and etc. So, like, this game is specifically a prequel to Final Fantasy VII and, like, the Final Fantasy VII world. But just something interesting that I to explain, but, you know, I guess some people might not know about that. Push a button. Do it.
What's that noise?
What you just did was release test samples.
Uh-oh.
Onto the lower floor.
Monsters?
Too ferocious to be of any use. I was about to get rid of them. Such timing. I charge you with their disposal.
What, me?
Oh, come on, man.
I will tell you something interesting. The detention cells on 67 are being used to store items.
On 67?
The monsters
what?
You just released each hold a key for those item storage cells. Those storage cells may be holding some useful items.
The way he talks is so goofy.
Try to get the keys from the monsters.
If you're interested, try to get the keys from those monsters.
However,
like, why is he talking like that?
Monsters, you'll need to figure out yourself.
Honestly, I don't find that very interesting at all.
Even if you fail, there is no need for concern. After 3 minutes, a tranquilizer gas will be released.
Did you hear me?
If you dispose of the monsters within 3 minutes, I will not report that you were responsible for the accident.
Okay, sounds good. But tranquilizer gas, you say? Is it gonna tranquilize me as well?
You won't need to worry if you finish within 3 minutes.
Okay, I don't remember this part of the game. I must have, like, not pushed the button or something. Or they just added this in, I don't know. But yeah, I'm pretty sure this was not part of the game where Ocho's like, hey, you pressed a button to unleash a bunch of monsters. Now you must kill them in an exact timer. Okay, just a bunch
hey,
of doggos.
Where are you going?
Oh no, the doggos are all running into different areas.
My eval and soldier pride is at stake. Come back here.
Push the button.
They're scattered all over the place. Gotta take them out fast.
So, I can take the items in the cells, right? The monsters have the keys to the cells. Now. How do I take them?
Oh, I need the steel materia. The detention cells contain items inside, but the doors are locked. The keys to the cells are held by the monsters, so if you can steal off of them, you may... I was just like, oh, I finally figured out what, like, how I'm supposed to get the keys, and then the game's just like, use the steel materia, you dummy! Okay. Thanks, game. Okay. Gotta equip the steel materia, I guess.
Here I come!
Activating combat mode.
Yay, got the jail key. Now time to kill it. Ow. Don't whip me. I'm glad that the timer stops when I'm in combat. That kind of ruins the point of the timer, but, like, okay. This thing doesn't stop moving very much, does it? It just keeps running around.
zone.
Activating combat mode.
Ow. Oh, that drains my MP too. Oh, geez.
Conflict resolved.
Like when they hit me with that shock whip, it hurts both my HP and MP. I don't like that.
There you are.
Activating combat mode.
Ouch.
Take that.
Conflict resolved.
Okay, so where are the other two doggos? Are they over here? In this area? Oh, yep, there's at least one.
There you are.
Activating combat mode.
Yoink. Look how each battle I just run up, grab the thing, and then I'm just gone. Stop.
Conflict resolved.
Oh yeah.
Okay, yeah, and then there's the last one. Okay.
Here's a cell. If I get a key, I can get in, right?
Yes, Zach. Good observation. Now let's kill this last one. I want my keys.
No escape.
Activating combat mode.
Yeah. Ooh, level up. Nice.
Okay, all done. There's some time left. I'll check the cells before returning.
All right. Oh, I still got the timer going. Uh-oh. Open it.
It's open.
Open the door, get the items. Silence. Ooh, that's a good spell. Either, okay. Attack up. Ooh, that one's good.
Good. It's open.
Soma. Thunder. And 3,000 gil. Okay, I'm just looting all of Shinra's stuff. 500 gil. 2,000 gil. And a cure. Okay.
Good.
Potions. A fire. And a high potion. This stuff's kind of normal, except for the silence one, but most of this other stuff's pretty standard stuff. HP up, okay. That's good.
There can't be anything in here.
Oh, is that a toilet? I can't really tell. It's super dark. Okay, then a potion.
Good.
Remedy. My potion. And two guild. They're like, eh, we've got some leftover pennies. Let's just drop them in here, I guess. Hey, cool dude.
All the monsters are down, and I checked all the cells.
Yes, good. Let's review, Zach.
Going back.
Okay, let's see. I got all the monsters. I looted everything from Shinra. Okay, yeah, and now I've got to walk back, pretend like nothing ever happened. Okay.
Ah, you disposed of the samples and ransacked every last cell. A good outing. First-rate work. Well done.
Thanks, Hojo.
I was able to acquire some intriguing data. The items you picked up are yours, but I locked all the cells once again. No more exploring for you.
Okay.
I must say, this is
a little weird, but all right, dude. Feels a little passive aggressive, just being like, yeah, I locked all the doors again, you idiot.
Don't use it for evil.
Cell Raider, okay. Guess now let's talk to him.
Purposeless.
Well, no. I have a purpose.
I thought you said I would have some visitors. Are you prepared to sacrifice your own life to protect this great intellect of mine?
Well, I...
Maybe not.
Of course you can count on me. Come and get it is what I say. I'll show them the power of the next generation of soldier firsts.
That is most encouraging. Don't lose against some failed project by a second-rate scientist. Oh? Well, look who's here.
Genesis is like, hey, yo, how's it going?
Hollander sent you, correct? You think that if you obey Hollander, he'll stop your body from degrading. Is that it? Pitiful. Just pitiful, I say.
Genesis.
A second-rate hack like Hollander.
Genesis's sword is like super long, by the way. Like, it's not quite Sephiroth length, but it's a pretty long sword.
My friend. The fates are cruel. There are no dreams. No honor remains. The arrow has left the bow of the goddess.
The entire cast of Hollander's freak show.
Shut up, you!
Loveless, Act 4.
Where the two friends challenge each other to a duel. An ancient epic. I read it thinking it might aid my research. But pure drivel.
How does the duel end?
Unknown. The last act is missing. And yet to be discovered.
The last act of Loveless is missing.
Theories.
Well, there's some property damage. You gotta pay for that, Genesis.
What is the meaning behind it? For us, at least.
Hey! Hold it, Genesis!
Okay.
My soul corrupted by vengeance.
Remember, I think there's a boss fight coming up here.
Hath endured torment to find the end of the journey in my own
salvation. It's another one of those summons. I know which one, but I'm gonna let it be revealed when it gets revealed.
He's summoning again.
Yeah, dang it, he spams summons all the time.
Huh?
You can do this. Trust me.
Don't leave me here! Stop! Come back! Aerith?
I have this part.
Listen, can I call you back later? I have some company.
There he is.
Don't keep your guest waiting, she says.
Man. The new voice actor for Zack still just doesn't... It doesn't land the punch for the voice acting. But yeah, it's okay, so here's Bahamut version 2, Bahamut Fury. You like the first Bahamut? Well, prepare to do another Bahamut fight. I really like what they did with the design here, though. They made it really well. Like, the remaking for this is really nice looking. Very clean. Gosh, I don't remember how this attack works. Okay. Bunch of explosions. I'm gonna use that healing wave now, because I'm at, like, half health.
Thanks.
And there we go. Cluster Sphere. Oh yeah, this is a pretty powerful attack, right? Yeah. Oh, do you have anything to steal? Dang it, he does, but... Oh, dang it, 75%? Oh, jeez. Oh, it... Also, if you thought that the summon, like, super moves weren't crazy enough, this guy uses the moon as an amplifier for his attack. So it's, yeah, it's a little bit on the crazy side. Oh jeez, I am out of AP and MP. Ow! Blink. So, a weird little quirk about this game is, if you have, rolling costs one, did they change it? They might have changed it. Okay, I remember at least in the first game, or not the first game, the original, didn't need to do that again. But yeah, in the original, rolling costed one, AP, so if you were out of AP, you just couldn't roll, which was really weird. Eh. Come on. Saying couldn't steal, which means that I can get something. High potion. I did all that work for a high potion. Anything more? Okay, nope. Just a high potion. Ooh, nice. Okay, we got it down to 50% at least. Still gonna take a bunch of damage, but we should be good. Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot that does a bunch of, like, MP and AP damage, too. I don't know why. Kind of annoying. Okay. Ethers. And Somas. And then I'll just use a regular potion. I've got a healing wave if we need it. Try to block this. Steel leveled up. That's good. Okay. Finally. Jeez. That was rough. Oh, we got him. So that's Bahamut Fury. I think that's the last of these summon boss fights. I think the summon boss fights are only there just because they tried to... They, like, wanted boss fights, but they didn't want it with, like, the key characters of the game yet. So they just, like, threw in these, like, summons.
Where did everyone go?
Save the game? Yeah, of course. And get some water, yep.
Come on, pick up.
Who are you calling?
Sephiroth. I just can't seem to get a hold of him.
Oh, haven't you heard? Word is, Sephiroth has shut himself inside the data room. In the data room,
Sephiroth sulking.
Devices are strictly prohibited. It's no wonder you can't reach him.
The data room?
Apparently, he's researching the history of the Shinra Science Department.
Oh,
What's up?
And my back hurts. That's kind of the one thing with chairs like this, which are, I guess, are called racer style chairs. They are kind of terrible for your back.
No, of course I didn't. Hold on, I'm coming.
Okay. Oh no. So now that we did all that crazy stuff with Bahamut Fury and like all the cool fighting, now it's time to go do the flower wagon part of the game. So that's gonna be real fun. But this time we gotta walk back to the slums, so it's a little confusing to get there, but we should be able to make it easily.
An inspection
talk
team
to you.
From a new Mako reactor site is coming to Midgard to see our operations, sir. However, inspections have been made difficult due to the presence of monsters in the area surrounding Midgar, sir. I'm a little concerned about my comrades assigned to escort the team, sir.
Okay. Oh, new mission added. Oh, interesting. I don't remember that being a thing where you could talk to people to get side quests. Like, you can talk to this dude?
Question. Do you know what is needed for Shinra to keep growing?
Money.
I will tell you what we need. It is Midgar's urban development.
Okay, dude.
Though known as the world's greatest commercial hub, Midgar still has problems that need
to be addressed. Exactly how to maximize our profits.
Like urban decay beneath the plate and the ever-increasing Mako energy consumption rate.
We at the City Planning Department are fully committed to improving the lives of Midgar citizens. But as we are not a military department, we find some problems to be out of our hands. Could Soldier provide assistance?
I see. Midgar's urban development, huh?
I'd be happy to help you guys. Just let me know whenever you need me.
Okay. And new mission, epic. I thought I saw a checkpoint earlier. Okay, it's over here. Gotta save, of course. I see save point, I go save. Okay, yeah, we gotta go over here. And, okay, we're gonna be wandering around for a little bit as I try to remember how to get to the place that we need to go. Or the game could just tell me. Oh, actually, that makes it so much nicer, because the game just tells you, yeah, you go over that way. Because I remember I was like, because the compass thing at the top was not in the original PSP version, so I remember I was like running around here trying to like look for any sort of like way to go and stuff, and not finding anything, and just being like, man, this place sure is empty. And, man, this place sure is empty. Okay. Yeah, then we go over here. And if you're wondering why there's all these, like, blue dotted lines and all that stuff, it's because, since it's just remaking the original PSP version, the PSP couldn't have these huge areas. It had to have a bunch of little zones, so.
Yeah.
And they just kind of kept that.
Can't reach Sephiroth either.
What's going on?
Nothing. He's just cooped up in the data room, looking into stuff in the past or something.
I see.
Whoa! You're taking off?
Right. Is what did you Angeal supposed to have his sword? It looks like he's holding a something, but he doesn't have his sword in his hand.
So you're still working?
I'm still a soldier member in spirit. I've informed Lazard. They'll pick you up.
Is he supposed to be looking away? Is there a bug? Am I experiencing bugs right now? Is that what's happening? This scene's kind of weird. Okay. You gotta run over to Aerith.
Zack, I need you in Modeoheim.
I know. Just give me a minute.
Aerith isn't there. Problem?
And how is it you know Aerith?
It's complicated.
Really?
Did she tell you anything?
Not a thing.
Then I won't either.
Also, don't worry about this helicopter landing behind me.
Well, whatever, I guess. Whatever.
Okay, so this is not the flower wagon part of the game. That's later. Oh no, the helicopter's crashing. Wait, I thought this part of the game was like way later, but it's now? Jeez. Yeah, so we're supposed to go to Modeaheim, and then all of a sudden the helicopter just suddenly crashes and now we're in the snow.
Song. Hey guys.
No signal out here.
Well, at least we're all in one piece. We'll be all right.
Thankfully, we have someone used to this kind of terrain.
Yeah, yeah. I'm a country boy.
All right, then. We would have reached Modeaheim by now if we hadn't crashed. So, we're going to need to make up for lost time.
All right. Follow me, then.
Yep, and we're time for more walking. Ooh. I like this environment, though. I like what they did with it. The nice mountain ranges.
Activating combat mode.
Okay, and then, of course, you know, not surprisingly, there's just an ostrich up here with, you know, claw hands. It's weak to blizzard and ice, or fire. I was about to say blizzard and ice, but that's the same thing in this game.
Too far behind. At least someone's keeping up. Well, I'm a country boy too. From where?
Oh yeah, no, there's... Well, we'll get to see who this character is.
How about you?
Me? Gungaga.
Hey, what's so funny about that? You know Gungaga? No, but it's such a backwater name.
Ditto Nibelheim. Like you've been there.
I think it's funny how Zach's from Gungaga.
There, right?
the name is funny to me.
Midgar usually means nothing else out there.
Good news, Song. Me and...
Whoa, it's Cloud. What the heck?
Backwater experts. Oh, yeah.
Good. Carry on, then.
Yeah, so this is where Cloud is originally... Well, this is where... In terms of the Final Fantasy timeline of games and stuff, this is where you meet him first. I don't know what I was saying with that, but that's Cloud. This is what he was before you see him in the main Final Fantasy VII game. And he's not an edgelord.
Activating combat mode.
Which is kind of the nicest part about Cloud in this game, is that he's just kind of a regular dude. He's not even a soldier yet, actually. Ow.
Conflict resolved.
There we go. Wait, magic finish? Oh, I killed the other guy. That's right. Killed the other guy with magic.
Combat
Why are these guys weak to blizzard, though? Like, we're in an ice area, and, like, enemies that are introduced in the ice area are weak to ice. A little strange, but, you know, it is what it is, I guess.
Guess I'll wait.
Imagine if we had to actually wait for them to walk all the way over here.
Hey,
with nothing happening. And they're just staring at them the whole time.
So, soldier, what's it like? Huh? I'm not getting the question. Well, you'll know once you join up. If I can join. Don't worry. If I can do it, you can. Cloud, look.
Oh, yeah. Then there's this segment of the game. This part is a little weird. I remember having a hard time figuring this out. Actually, no, I think I did pretty okay. I remember as a kid, I could not figure this part out. It's kind of weird, but... And basically, this is going to be kind of like a little bit of like a stealth section.
Genesis.
Or at least a try to see if you can stealth section.
Okay, I'll check it out.
Our main mission here is reconnaissance. Engaging Genesis was not expected.
Not expected? So just let them be? Unreal.
In any case, we need more intel. It's possible that a larger force is hiding inside the building.
How's this then? I go first, avoiding combat if possible, and sneak inside. Then, I take a look around. If I can take them, I will. If not, I'll bolt. Come on, man. I'll prove that Soldier isn't just a bunch of mindless thugs.
All right.
I accept your challenge.
Behind that warehouse. Make your way in from there.
Gotcha.
I'm sure you know, but it'll be cold. Mind your body temperature. If you stop moving, your body temp will go down.
Oh, yeah. There's like a body temp thing or mechanic for just this part. It's really random. Okay, let's, yeah, there's a save point down here, so let's tap it real quick. Oh. And then, I think we're, okay, so, okay, it's kind of a little weird, but so look around a little more means back off. Confirm tactics means get the tutorial. Confirm tactics and infiltrate means get the tutorial and then go. So it's a little weird. Still here, popped into another stream of someone I haven't seen in a while. They started talking about dating life at a kind of town. Alright, well, glad you stopped by back over here, but... Yeah, we're in the snow now. Don't know exactly where you dipped out, but... okay, confirm tactics and infiltrate. So, let's get the tutorial here. Is he not cold? Well, we're gonna have to deal with the body temperature mechanic in this specific area, so... I guess so. Okay. The guards are constantly patrolling the facility. If you are detected, they will give chase and a battle will ensue if they catch up to you. So you can hide. You can escape detection by crouching behind objects like steel barrels. While hiding in marked areas, you'll not be detected. Oh, so I can just hide there? Even though, when the guy's walking that way, he would be able to see me. But since I'm in the sneak zone, I'm fine. Okay. Let's see. Give your body temperature up. Your body temperature will go down if you stay in one place for too long. When your body temperature hits 26.0, you fail the mission. So warm your body up by doing squats. So yeah, we have a squat button. Yeah, and then there's 5 containers in total, but you lose one if the following occurs. You have to do a battle, you go outside the fence, basically, or you did by temperature drops too low. Okay, let's stay over here and crouch down. We're sneaky. And then go in here. I'm stealth. I am stealth. Okay, wait, so he won't see me when he's walking back, right? That's how this works, based on what I've been told. Yep, nope, he literally just looked at me and he didn't see me. Okay, let's go. Now, the question is how am I supposed to go anywhere when they're all over here? Okay, let's do some squats. Okay, go back to stealth. I did one squat, and then I have to crouch again. Man, they're like patrolling so thoroughly, man. What am I supposed to do? Okay, time for squats. Hello? I'm pressing the squat button. Man, it is kind of janky to control the squats. Okay, let's try to yoink this. Power attack! Let's go. Okay, they seem kind of blind anyways. I've been playing so many stealth games that it's like when a game has like kind of rudimentary stealth mechanics like this, I'm kind of confused. The squat is so weird. It's like you have to like mash it, I guess. Very weird. Okay, there's a stealth area over there. Let me try to get over here. No, you're not in the stealth area. There we go. Okay. Doink. Ooh, we got stopped. That's actually really good. That's a super useful ability. I don't know how it's weird. It's like I press triangle to do the squat, and then my controller vibrates, and then sometimes he just does another one again, and sometimes he stops doing the squats, and I don't know how to make it consistent. Oh, I have to wait until after. Oh, what the? He watched me squat too much. Okay, that was kind of dumb, but all right. And all that work of squatting for no reason. Well, guess we lost one of those boxes. Yep, because they opened it, so we lost it. Dispel! Oh no, not dispel! Dispel's so good, man. If dispel is basically it removes all status effects on the target. Not yet. Thank you very much. Wait, what? Why did that happen? That was weird. Okay, I'm just gonna stay here until they get into a position where I can get over to that hiding spot again. Okay. So now we gotta go over that way. Because we explored everything over here that we could. Question is, how do we get over there without being spotted? So I think that guy's gonna head towards that way. Right? Or no, he's walking back. You are walking to... Okay, you're going all the way over there. Okay. It's the patrol routes, though. Like, literally, when is it my time to go? It is, like, the world's greatest question. okay. Excuse me, you won't see me going next to you. Oh gosh, I love this. Okay, now that we're back here, we're pretty much home free. And we got all the rest of them. Let's go. Okay, now we're in there. Jeez. I do like that because it's the... at least from my experience with playing through the PSP version, there wasn't those hiding spots in there, so... It made it a lot harder, but we got it. We only missed Dispel. What was the other one we got? I think, okay, so we got Regen, we have Thundera, got a lot of poison? Why do we have so many poisons? When did that happen? Power attacks, a bunch of HP ups, apparently. Okay. Let's do some materia fusion stuff just to get through this. Okay, that doesn't actually do anything. Yeah, so these other HP ups don't actually affect with the fusion thing at all. Which is kind of annoying. We can get HP up plus 90%. Holy crap, man. I think that's actually kind of worth it. I mean, we lose the mastered blizzard, but I mean, we get a lot of HP, so. And then I can combine the cures. That's a little bit better. And I think I can combine Cure with something else to get, like, a Kira, maybe? Okay, yeah, I can combine it with Stop for Kiraga, but I don't really want to do that because Stop is super powerful. I can replace it. I can get rid of Silence. Silence is not that useful. I mean, so Silence makes it so that the target can't use magic, like magic stuff. Which I don't think is super important. I think we can get silence elsewhere, so. Unless there's other things that could give us Kira. Which it's not looking like. Let's at least get Kira. Kira is pretty useful. And then I guess we could just combine the fires. Boost that up a little bit. Combine the thunders. And I guess combine some of these poisons? I don't know why I have so many. This doesn't make any sense. Wait, does this actually... Oh, okay, I don't think that actually does anything. Because they're all level 1 poisons. Okay. Does combining power attack with anything do give us anything good? Alright, we also have the attack up, which I might want. Oh wait, no, I can combine Assault Twister with that, right? Well, that gives us just a plus 5 attack, Assault Twister. Silence aerial? Enables aerial attacks that silence the enemy. That's actually kind of cool. I've never seen that before. Or Stop Twister? Wait, hold on. Why does the... Wait, what? Why does the stop thing enable a silencing attack, but poison enables a stopping attack? Wait, what? It'll make no sense, man. Oh, I forgot about this. You can combine an HP up with the Salt Twister, so you get the benefit of an HP up with just the ability of a Salt Twister. Okay, let's do that. That seems really useful. Plus, it's 110% HP increase. And it frees up a materia slot, so we can use that materia for something else. And we could just make it even better if we wanted to. I am curious about the stop twister, but I don't want to use this assault twister. So we do not have another assault twister. Dang it. Okay. Can I do anything with this? It's just a poison blade. Okay. Okie dokie then. So let's see. We can put the assault twister on X, please. And let's put. We have a Thundara, which is really useful. I need to combine those together. Let's get fire there, I guess. Or actually, no. That the blizzard could be leveled up. And then let's put a. Oh gosh, I can have even more HP. So I'm just going crazy with the equipment stuff right now. This attack up only gives a plus one, but if we level it up, then it could do better. So let's equip that. And then let me go to Materia Fusion. Find the Thunder with the Thundara. Make a better Thundara. Go. And is there anything if I combine these two? Dark Blizzard. Okay, this is actually new. Look at this. So it does an ice attack that poisons, silences, and stuns the enemy. That does three completely different side of or like status effects. That's I'm really interested in this. And Dark Blizzard. It's such an edgy name. I've never seen that before. I've never seen the Dark Blizzard.
Activating combat mode.
Okay, so Assault Twister, boom. Okay, and then... Okay, you're gonna cast Stop on me, which missed, I think. And Dark Blizzard. Okay, get hit by this, though. Oh, he might not be able to get affected by, like, poison and stuff, because he's, like, a super enemy. Dang it, man. Ow. Okay, never mind. Heal, please. There we go. Oh, he can cure? Hey, no healing. Only I'm allowed to do that. There we go.
Okay.
And yeah, restore HP to full. Okay, I need to swap out the steel because I don't use the steel. I guess we go with jump. I like the jump. It's fun to jump.
Activating combat mode.
Right there. Oh. Okay, try out Dark Blizzard. Why does it not give you status effects, man? Does it work on that guy? Ow. Okay, he's poisoned. Stop kicking me, dude. I like how instead of using his gun, he just runs up and kicks me. Okie dokie, so now we got the treasure here. An axe potion. Excellent. And we went the wrong way, I think. I think we're supposed to go the other direction from where we came in. Okay, time to do some more running and probably some more fights. Unless we can dodge them. Unless we can just dodge them. Yeah, we have to go this way.
Activating combat mode.
So we can check out Cloud's limit break. This one's really cool. I like this one a lot. Just a bunch of meteors. hello. There we go. Ooh, level up. I feel like I'm leveling up a lot more than I did in the PSP version of this game.
Activating combat mode.
Okay. Time for some Gatners.
Conflict resolved.
Oh yeah.
There we go.
What's the meaning?
Ooh, look at those sandals.
You need me, Genesis. Remember that. If you get rid of me, who's going to stop the degradation?
What are those? Gosh, remember that meme.
The Genova cells.
Might be a little hard to tell in the lighting, but Genesis's hair is like starting to gray.
But nobody knows where the Genova cells are being kept. Not even Hojo knows. You'll never find it.
Then I shall willingly accept my fate. But I'll take the world with me.
Cloud! Go!
Hey, Cloud, go! Why? Oh, I bet he caught it. I'm glad that when it comes to the choreography of the, like, oh yeah, now we got to fight Genesis, so, you know, that's cool. Black Flurry? Uh-oh. Yeah, I like how for the cutscenes that are, ow. Don't do that to me. I'm trying to talk here, man, and you keep hitting me. Stop. Okay, now he's got defense. That's cool. I need to use, hello? There we go. Okay, I don't think this... I think I need to use a remedy here. Okay. Yeah, because those status effects weren't going away. Ow. Ow. Whoops. Oop. And Dark Blizzard again. Okay, let's use meter shots. Okay, so now that I got this, what I was saying earlier was I'm glad that the, like, in-game engine cutscenes have the same choreography as the PSP versions. Like, just a fun little thing. Oh yeah, he's got his barrier on. So I have to use magic because physical defense or physical attacks do not work on him, right? Well, no, now they do, because the barrier's gone. Ow, oof. That's a lot of damage. Don't cast regen on yourself, you cheater. Man. Ooh, we got Mega Flare. Okay, obviously use it. Use the big blam attack. Doink. Gosh, he heals so much health. Ooh, okay, I just tanked all those. Ow. Man, his regen is so powerful and it lasts for so long. Ooh, we got meter shots. Let's use that.
The power of soldier.
All right, here comes the big one.
Okay, good chunk of damage there. Just gotta wail on him a bit more. He's a bit of an HP sponge. Ow, I just took all of those to the face. Whoops, I pressed the X button to roll, but I was still holding L1, so I tried to use the assault twister instead. Man. Okay, is there anything in here I need to look at? The attack up doesn't do a whole lot, but if I level up, maybe it does something. Is there any better version of the bronze bangle? Nothing that gives me more HP, but maybe perhaps more attack? That might be useful. Alright, well, he uses a lot of, like, magic stuff, so I think I'm gonna go with the amulet, which increases my spirit stat, which spirit stat basically is your magic defense. Okay, so let's try that. Okay, magic defense, that's perfectly fine with me, because I can just use, whoops. Yeah, I was accidentally holding the L1 button there again. Ah, crap. Please don't. Oh, hi, Slinky. How you doing? We're just in the middle, like, dead in the middle of Crisis Core here. I gotta use that remedy. Take that. I pressed the wrong button. Ow, ow, ow. Okay, that was just me pressing the wrong button. Okay. Only use magic against you now. And he, I think, outpaces my heal or my magic. Ow. Sir. Ow. Gosh, dude. This is kind of an annoying fight right now. And he renewed his physical damage thing? What? Come on, dude. Please don't kill me. Ow. Yeah, he's got this stinking magic defense. Does this work? Watching Matt suffer in this fight. I know, I'm struggling with this one right now. Enjoy my lunch and enjoy the suffering. Yeah, you eat your lunch and you like it. Oh. Ouch. Oof, okay, that was a bit of a bad one. Now let's do this again. Makes me want to go back to fighting those mutant intestines. Yeah, I don't know. That's kind of like a, you know, weighing the options, you know? It's like kind of a... That's a hard choice, that one. Ether. Ow. Let me, okay. Oh, we got it. Oh, okay. It took us forever, but we got it. The shattered soul. Dark Souls boss right there, apparently. Pride
is lost. Wings stripped away. The end is nigh.
Yeah, Slinky, do you... What is your knowledge of Final Fantasy? Have you just watched it? Have you played some of it? Or is it something you've never heard of? Because apparently we've had people like that, too. We're soldier. Where's your honor? Which honestly was a surprise to me that there's some people who have just never heard of Final Fantasy.
Is barren of promises. Nothing shall forestall my return.
Zero knowledge, but I did used to play some piano songs from Final Fantasy. Okay, that's kind of cool, actually. Yeah, this is a kind of a random one to start with, and also just kind of like in the like the middle of it all. So, Xanarchy was my favorite. Oh yeah, that's a great song right there. Great song. And you just hear he just falls lands on the ground. Don't know how it happened. okay, yeah, so we got Genesis added to the DMW. He's got this weird special gimmick thing. Yeah, he's got Genesis mode. So when a limit verge occurs during normal DMW mode, Genesis image reel will sometimes be added. This means the DMW has entered Genesis mode, and when his image reels match, a corresponding limit break move will be added to your stock. The Genesis image reel may become unavailable when proceeding to a new chapter, among other reasons, but it'll reappear when Genesis mode becomes available again. Okay, that's a little random, but I guess that makes sense. But yeah, he's just kind of like a... It's a limit break that you sometimes get, and it's pretty good, but... Anyways.
Song? Cloud? Where are they?
That's a great question, Zach.
What is that hole? Did they go in?
Okay, Oh, we can hit the save point over here. It's been a hot minute since my last save. Like a whole 9 minutes. And then there's just a save point over here. Okay. But yeah, we're close to a very interesting point in the game. That won't make sense if you haven't been following along this playthrough so far, but it'll still be kind of cool, I guess. it'll be kind of like a wow, pretty colors kind of thing. Ow, I just got hit by the ostrich butt. Ooh, there we go, there's that Genesis mode. Let's see if we can get it. Go, and... Apocalypse, level 5. So... This one's just, like, kind of all over the place. Yeah, so, that's what that move does. Here's a treasure. MP up, okay. Zara. Go. Yeah, so this is... this is Crisis Core, which is a prequel game to Final Fantasy VII.
Activating combat mode.
Okay, gotta fight some beetles. Ow. I like how they're called bizarre bugs. Just, you know, very strange bugs, you know?
Conflict resolved.
Oh, yeah!
And, oh wait, what's this?
Looks like I have some voicemail messages.
What? I've never seen this before, what the heck? I think I've heard enough. this is a bathhouse that we're in. Or what was once a bathhouse.
Activating combat mode.
Bring it on!
Ow. Trying to use my cool AoE move, but you know, you can just ignore it. Oh, I think we made a new enemy here. Man, look at the cool, decrepit bathhouse. Like, one of the few games that just, like, a bathhouse is just kind of part of it, you know? Like, it's just kind of there. Man, look, it's like a griffin. Kind of. It's kind of a griffin, right? Oh, it's literally called the griffin. Okay, never mind. He just flew into me. Oh, and I got stunned. Uh-oh. Ow. Okay, I guess that was down attack. This guy's got a lot of different abilities. I kind of don't like it. Let me just chuck some meteors at him real quick.
The power of soldiers.
Oh gosh, he can't. Okay, so wall is a kind of annoying spell that basically increases physical and magical defense. it basically just means that we can't hurt him very much for like a really long period of time. I need to heal. And okay. Oh. Man, he keeps using drain. Really annoying. Ow. Oh crap, I got stunned. Go. Yeah, not too bad, just kind of a HP sponge again.
And geo monsters. Does that mean he's here?
I don't know. Oh, okay. Hello. I was not expecting enemies right over here. There we go. Okay, so I think the way to get to that, because yeah, we just can't go into the water. It's too hot, even though we're in the mountains and it's all the windows are broken.
Is there any way I can cool things down?
Yeah, I remember there was a way to cool off the water, but I don't think that the thing in that chest was that worth.
Oops.
I guess we have to fight more dogs. They just showed up again and are like, please play with us, we want to murder you. Ow. Ow, I'm dying. I've gotten hit by like every single one of their fireballs.
Conflict resolved.
Okay. I'm trying to see if I can remember where you have to go. There's like a lever. There's some sort of, like, valve you have to turn or something. Oh, okay. I guess we're going to go see if we can find it elsewhere.
Activating combat mode.
Ow. Yeah, hey, Kira leveled up. Nice. Okay, we found this thing. And a boiler handle. And I think we gotta go over here to put it somewhere. Question is where?
Activating combat mode.
Okay, excuse me, I have to kill some dogs real quick. Maybe we go up? I know, but up's the more story stuff, and probably not up here. Where do we put the thing at? It's probably over here somewhere. Anything that... Oh, okay. There's a treasure over there, so we can at least get that.
Conflict resolved.
Oh, yeah.
Let's restore the bowl. Hey, high potion. Let's go. I don't remember where you have to put this handle in. Doesn't look like there's anything over here. And let me just progress in the story. I think there's probably a spot where we can put it.
Activating combat Activating combat mode.
Bring it on! Take that!
Yo, level up! Let's go!
Hey!
Oh no, Cloud's dead! No! The time paradox! Final Fantasy VII can't happen if Cloud's dead!
I'm okay.
Song! Song!
Up ahead, you have to catch Hollander. And Geo is waiting for you.
I was about to ask, did Hollander, just a normal human scientist, beat up those two? But no, and Geo helped. Okay, and still no spot for the boiler handle, huh? Oh well, I'm sure it's fine. Excuse me, Cloud. Okay, so I think there's a few more rooms here.
There's something inside here, but the steam's too hot to go through.
Oh no, that steam's too hot. Oh no. We can't possibly grab it. Oh wait, treasure. I must get the treasure. I'm a loot goblin, so I love grabbing treasure. Even if I don't like it, I just I like having it.
That there is a slot for something.
Oh, this is where we put the boiler handle. Oh, okay. And then we turn the valve. And that stops, and that's it, apparently. Does that fix the hot water in the other area? I thought it did.
Activating combat mode.
Okay, now we can grab it. Hello? Now, let's grab this big glowing rock. A lightning armlet. I think that just reduces lightning damage? But let's see if it fixes the hot water or whatever. I'm gonna guess no, but let's see. See if it fixes it. It does fix it, let's go! Oh, it is dispel. Okay, that's actually kind of worth.
Conflict resolved.
There we go. Okay, so now back over here. Let's save. You know, the interesting thing is, I'm pretty sure in the PSP version, because this is a remake of the original PSP game, for those coming in who don't know, and I think that this opening was like a loading screen, and then you went up here, went through this, and then it was another loading screen. Like, there was loading screens everywhere, and they only cut out, like, a few of them. Oh, hello. Ow.
Later. Conflict resolved.
Oh, wait, this is the story part. Uh-oh. Hopefully this boss fight goes well, because there's a boss up here that's really annoying to fight. It does a lot of damage, and I probably should equip that lightning armlet because that's super useful in this fight.
I should have dealt with Genesis.
Yeah. Then why'd you send me?
To prepare you. for your next fight.
Have you lost it? Stop it!
Someone's waiting for you, no?
Angeal, don't do this.
Very good, Angeal. It is time to exact vengeance for our family's suffering.
Family?
No! My father is dead!
Fine. Then do it for your mother.
My mother's shame made her take her own life!
Shame? How terribly misguided. She should have been proud. Proud that she was the namesake of our experiment. Project G. Or should I say, Project Jillian?
Mama Angeal.
Don't say her name.
Jillian, the woman implanted with Genova cells. Genesis, who had her genes mapped onto him during the fetal stage. Yes, Genesis was a failure.
But yeah, admit it. Yeah, Mama Angeal's super important because
you were actually bred inside Jillian's body.
Yeah, Angeal's a bred to be a soldier, as in the all caps superhuman soldier. Monster. As opposed to all the other ones who just get injected with like super juice.
A two-way conduit. Genova's power has passed on to you completely.
Zack, do you remember what I said about our enemy being all that creates suffering?
Yeah, but you're not one of them.
But I created my own suffering.
Whoa, that's Zack, deep, man.
Let me show you.
Stop it! You don't know what you're doing!
Yeah, this is a...
At least one sample!
This is where the game gets a little weirder. As if it wasn't weird enough already, but it gets a little weirder.
Angeal!
So all the weird Angeal cloned monsters, I'll give him a big group hug, and then he goes Super Saiyan. And the shot's a little too wide in my opinion, but yeah, Angeal becomes whatever the heck this thing is. Yeah, so it's this is the boss fight I was talking about. Angeal-mon. Or Angeal-mon.
Activating combat mode.
Okay. Yeah, he's got all these weird names for his attacks too. He hurts for a lot. Ooh, okay, he's weak to ice. That's good. He gets to use this one lightning move that's like really hard to deal with.
Is this the end?
Digimon reference.
No, not if I can help it.
Oh, hello. That was weird. Ow. Hello? I'm using cure. There we go. God dang it, man. Of pride. He's kind of got like a Seven Deadly Sin vibe going on, where all of his moves are like Word of Deadly Sin. Like, he's got Charge of Greed, he's got Defense of Lust. It's kind of like all things kind of relating to that kind of stuff. Oh, it's his magic defense that's increased, okay. Ow. Uh-oh. Oh boy, that's close. I was at 5 HP. Block pretty quick after the jump attack. That's actually kind of nice. Okay, now his physical defense is up. Uh-oh. Oh, come on. He got 100% power up for that. What was I supposed to do? His physical defense was up. So I had to use magic, and my magic's slow. Okay, he uses his crotch mouth cannon to just blast me. Uh-oh, I was literally dead there because he just charged me right after, and I even blocked it, but it's just wasn't able to tank enough damage. Okay. Here we go again. Okay, so that's up to attack plus 4. That's actually kind of nice. Thunder is not going to be much use here. I think I want a barrier thing. Probably more like a physic or like just a regular barrier. Stop's not gonna work because the one fun thing about bosses in like a lot of Final Fantasy games is that you can usually count on them being completely immune to every single status effect in the game, which is very cool. Okay, let's do barrier. Even though it's only a level 1 barrier, it's better than nothing. Okay. Let's try it again. Okay, activate the barrier. So now my physical defense is up. See, so he does significantly less damage to me. And I'm gonna immediately use this. Out. Oh yeah, he's the physical damage. Forgot about that. Yeah, so we're only taking like 100 damage instead of like almost 300 damage from his melee attacks. Just nice. And basically nothing from those. This is still gonna do quite a bit. That's magic. Okay, now it's magical defense. Ow. Barrier back up. Yeah, it's basically just kind of like a lot of like hits I gotta do. Okay, at least I got the down to 75%. That's a little bit better. Ah, crap, I died again. No, you gotta love it, man, when you just have this super annoying boss fight. Okay, let's go again. See, anything I can improve with my equipment? Did it save from last time? Yes, it did. Okay. Is there anything that we might want to replace jump with? I don't know, I actually kind of like the jump, because then I can, I get to dodge some of his attacks sometimes. I don't know, I think I just have to get good, keep a good eye on my HP, and, not die. That, spam some spells. Gonna charge at me. Okay, I was trying to move there, but it didn't work. Ether. Yep, that's just kind of how it goes. I guess we just gotta. Just wait for him to do his move, and then just take the opening to dish out some damage. Oh, we gained another memory, but this time with Sung.
Wow, they really did a number on this place.
The other Turks and I will track their movements. After that, it's all up to you.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay, cool memory, dude. airstrike!
Is this the end?
No, not if I can help it.
And does some damage. His magic defense is up, okay. Oh, really? Ow. Okay, here's the barrier. It's Kira. Oops. Oh, I didn't mean to use the... You gotta love when you don't let go of L1 in time, so it uses the spell instead of you just attacking regularly. Okay. We're hurting, but we live. And we get that airstrike, which I'm gonna do after this. Okay, airstrike. Hello. Okay, now he has defense up against physical attacks. There we go in with this. End of Gluttony. This is his crazy heal spell, apparently. Alright, whoops. Thanks for healing, man. That makes me feel so good when you just spam heals. Sure, let's do an airstrike. Actually, I wonder if that airstrike cancels that move he's charging up. Guess we'll see. Because he's charging up the Rage of Sloth attack. Uh-oh. Oh, he still got that up. We can get the summons out, hopefully. Nope, we did not get the summon. That's what I wanted to do. Nope, his magic defense is increased.
We can't have them calling.
Hey, another flashback. I think this one's kind of funny.
I'll draw their attention. Make sure you take them out.
Yeah, you got it.
Turks, get him!
They're like, hi, oh, I missed them. Oh no, there's an awkward moment. Or I missed them.
Soldier, everyone, get out here!
And then,
what are you doing? They called for backup.
Sorry, jumped too far.
Okay, let's do another. Why are we getting so many airstrikes? Oh, it's because the song it has heightened emotions on the DMW. So basically, we just get an increased chance for this move. Ooh, okay, we brought it down to 25. Oh, we broke it. Nice. Ow. Okay, we got another memory. So, if you're confused why these memory things are popping up, the idea is because the whole game's about like Zack's memories and like with all these different characters, and these are just kind of like flashback moments.
Looks can be deceiving. Thanks. I owe you.
Glad to be of service.
So yeah, that's kind of why they're all happening. Let me use my barrier, and then use the meteor shots.
The power of soldiers.
I just realized that there's a skip button on those. Do you guys want me to skip those? I don't know. I kind of like them, but. Okay, we finally got that was so long. That's about how long it took me to do it. When I was playing through this other PSP, it's just a super long boss fight. Ah, but we finally got it. Oh boy.
Zack. You have my thanks. This is for you. Protect your honor, always. Embrace your dreams. If you want to be a hero, you need to have dreams and honor.
And so that's how Zack gets the Buster Sword.
Hey, Zack? The sky is closer in the city above, right? Kinda scary. But the flowers might like it. Maybe.
Again.
Yeah,
It's okay, chat. You can cry. Okay. And then Zach just casually lets his hair grow out super long. He's like, so cool. Bunk. I appreciate the reference, Ellie. Yes, Zach has unleashed his Bankai.
So you want to be a soldier? Hang in there. So, is everybody here now?
Sir!
So, I think the reason why you I don't really like... Right? This voice actor for Zach, at least, just kind of like,
piece of advice.
I don't feel like it fits Zach, is because when he goes to this point, he looks kind of like that, more like a battle-hardened warrior kind of style, you know? And that voice he has just doesn't really fit that, in my opinion. Excuse my language, but he has reached what? I'm not sure if I understand that one, Ellie, but sure, yeah, definitely.
Whatever happens, protect your soldier honor. Got it?
Sir!
We're all coming back here alive. You hear me?
Yeah, the original voice actor for Zach that was used in pretty much every project that Zach's character was in, except up until this one, or in this like remake, his name is Rick Gomez, and I would highly recommend watching like some cutscenes with his voice actor, because even though the audio quality is not as good, because it was like the PSP, so it's like, you know, like back in like PS3 generation stuff, or like Xbox 360, and then like, you know, that handheld console, like, kind of low quality stuff, but in terms of like the actual performance, I like it a lot better. But I've definitely gotten more used to the voice actor for this version.
Project G was Angeal's mother's experiment,
and I think we're just gonna wait until we get through this cutscene, and then I'll probably end the stream here.
The company put me on standby. That was a while ago. Shinra is in disarray. The Turks are hanging around me every day. They say our vacations overlapped coincidentally. Yeah, right.
Oh, I forgot about this part of the if this is the part that I'm thinking of.
Not a whisper. Almost as if they never existed. Is that how little soldier is worth?
It's a very interesting contrast to everything that's been going on right now.
Do I have left to fight for? What is soldier honor?
Yep. We're at the beach now. And there's Zach in just, you know, swimsuit as you do, you know, doing his signature squats.
Suntan lotion?
No. Never mind that. What is this? Are they...
Waifu.
You could use some R&R.
I'm bored. That's it? I'm calling them.
Director Lazard's not in. He's been missing for a while now. It was Lazard who was funding Hollander's research. Using the company's money.
Are you serious?
We're interrogating Hollander, so we should learn more soon.
Oh yeah, so I think with this, it explains that Lazard was kind of in with Hollander. What are they all so thinking? Lazar was also kind of evil, in a way.
But even truth seems suspect once it leaves their mouths.
Cisne, go do something.
Calling Aerith?
Go do something, because it's a big...
Am I being watched?
No, she's the one being watched.
Huh?
That girl is an ancient. The only one left in the world. You didn't know?
She never said anything. The only one left in the world, huh? She is one of a kind.
Heads up. Right, and then Song's still just in his full outfit. Yeah, it's not an anime game if they don't have a beach episode segment.
Here? Activating combat mode.
Yeah, so we use the freaking umbrellas or weapon. Sure, we could use the Hellfire. Right? I think what makes this, like, whole, like, beach segment, like, really, like, funny and also kind of well done is the fact that it comes immediately after the super emotional, like, scene with Angeal dying and everything, and then, like, Zack being, like, unsure of, like, the future. Because it gives time for those things to play out, but then it's, like, it tries to bring it back to kind of a more light, like kind of a lighter moment. And so it just has this.
These guys are still around, but Genesis.
It's like,
Genesis.
A good story has, like, you know, its ups and downs, and like has those ups and downs paced well. And I think they do it really good with this.
A river of souls circles the planet. Perhaps Genesis's soul is also...
Controlling copies from the life stream? Is that what you're saying?
Just a supposition. In any case, your vacation's over.
Dang it. Come with me. I wanted more time at the beach, though. By an unknown force.
This is bad. Genesis copies again. They're just running wild.
Activating combat mode.
Okay. Oh, Buster Sword stance. Now wielding the Buster Sword, Zack has learned to take a battle stance? Okay, this is new. There's no battle stances in the original version. By expending AP, Zack can change to a stance which has a guarding effect. So it's square plus X. Okay. When in the battle stance, the attack command is changed to strong attack, which greatly increases the impact of abilities. Furthermore, Zack does not flinch when it attacked. Ooh. Okay. The more Zack uses the Buster Sword, the greater his proficiency becomes with the weapon, and which in turn provides many beneficial effects during battle. For this reason, you should use battle stance and strong attack along with abilities as often as possible. Ooh, and then Necrozmos. Okay. Which is also new. While wielding the Buster Sword, Zack has gained the Necrozmos effect. Your store is a little MP and AP every time Zack defeats an enemy with attack or abilities. That's so good, because I use like spells and stuff all the time. Okay, so if I go like hi-ya.
This is gonna sting.
Ooh.
How about this? Gonna love this.
Oh, and there's like new lines. That's actually super cool. I love this.
Taking you down. This is gonna sting.
That's super cool. No, that wasn't in the original game. When the Buster, when you got the Buster Sword, basically nothing changed gameplay-wise. That's actually really cool. I like that a lot.
It's not over yet, is it?
We'll evacuate the residents. You work on securing Hollander.
I'm securing Hollander? Don't you need me on the battlefield?
Hollander has top secret information. The president says he's priority one. With Director Lazard absent, Soldier's chain of command is shaky at best. These attackers exploited that weakness. Zack, you're the only one who can move freely. You must secure Hollander.
Hollander is being held at the 8th level detention center in Upper...
I'm sorry, I'm zoning out, Song. What do you say?
Zack, we need this.
He's still being interrogated. He can't fall into enemy hands.
Okay, I'll go.
Okay, and... Okay, I'm going to hit this save point, and then we're going to end the stream here. So, a-boop. And I'm going to end this for the, actually, I'll just keep it on the save screen. I'm going to end the recording.